I'm Aisha and I'm in Dakar, the capital of Senegal. Not that long ago, in September, Senegal was being praised for its handling of COVID-19 pandemic. This success was due to the effectiveness of its response at the beginning of the epidemic. Among other measures, rapid tests, hospital treatment for all positive cases. If you are in contact with a positive case, you are ordered to quarantine in a hotel paid by the government, land and air borders were closed, and travel between cities were banned. After that, the country experienced a downward trend, and one could think that the fight against COVID-19 was already won. However, Senegal is now experiencing a second wave. From about 10 or less positive cases at the beginning of November, the daily average stands now at more than 200. So, many restrictions have been reinstated. For example, a ban on gathering on beaches, sports fields and theatres, a limit on the number of passengers on public transports, the wearing of masks, it remains mandatory in all public and private places. You can't go out after 9 in the evening in Dakar and the nearby region of Thiès. However, schools remain open. The fact that they were closed at the beginning of the pandemic, when there were fewer than 100 positive cases, and that they are now open, is worrying some pupils. So far, authorities haven't said anything about the issue, but they continue to insist on measures like wearing masks, washing hands, and social distancing. And this time, to fight the virus, they also count on vaccination. I don't know if it has started in your country, but here, first doses are due to arrive next month.